Hello everyone, this is Dr. Adel Bondok, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience. Today I will talk about the nerves of the lower limb. The lower limb is supplied by the lumbar plexus and the sacral plexus. The lumbar plexus gives two nerves. The femoral nerve, it supplies the anterior compartment of the thigh and it arises from L2, 3 and 4. Second branch is the obturator nerve. It supplies the medial compartment of the thigh and it arises from L2, 3 and 4. Femoral nerve arises from the posterior divisions and the obturator nerve arises from the anterior divisions. The sacral plexus gives the gluteal nerves, superior and inferior gluteal nerves. The superior gluteal nerve supplies gluteus medius, gluteus minimus, and the tensor fasciae lata. The inferior gluteal nerve supplies the gluteus maximus. Second branch is the sciatic nerve. The sciatic nerve arises from L4, L5, and S1, 2, and 3. The sciatic nerve divides into two terminal branches, the common peroneal nerve and the tibial nerve. Start by the femoral nerve. This is the femoral nerve. Okay, we'll talk about the origin, the course, and the branches. Regarding the origin, it arises from the posterior divisions of L2, 3, and 4. Regarding the course, it lies between the psoas muscle and iliacus muscle. It is outside the femoral sheath. It is lateral to the femoral artery. This is the femoral artery. Regarding the branches, any nerve gives cutaneous branches to the skin, muscular branches to the muscles, and articular branches to the joints. Regarding the cutaneous branches, it gives three cutaneous branches: medial cutaneous nerve of the thigh, this one; intermediate cutaneous nerve of the thigh. This is the medial, this is the intermediate, and the longest one is the saphenous nerve. Then muscular branches. Muscular branches, quadriceps, sartorius, iliacus, and pectineus. Regarding the quadriceps, this is the rectus femoris. This is vastus medialis, vastus lateralis, and vastus intermedius. Then articular branches to the hip joint and the knee joint. Regarding the obturator nerve, this is the obturator nerve. It arises from the anterior divisions of L2, 3, and 4. It is divided by the adductor brevis, this is the adductor brevis, into anterior division and the posterior division. This is the anterior division, anterior to the adductor brevis, and this is the posterior division, posterior to the adductor brevis. Regarding the branches, also remember cutaneous, muscular, articular. So cutaneous branches, only the anterior division. The anterior division gives the cutaneous branch to the middle third of the medial side of the thigh. Muscular branches, anterior division supplies three muscles: adductor longus, adductor brevis, and gracilis, number four. The posterior division supplies two muscles: adductor magnus, the pubic part of adductor magnus, and obturator externus. Articular branches, each division supplies a joint. The anterior division supplies the hip joint, the posterior division supplies the knee joint. Then the sciatic nerve. This is the sciatic nerve. Talk about the origin, course, termination. Here is the termination of the sciatic nerve and the branches. Regarding the origin, it arises from L4, L5, S1, 2, and 3. Regarding landmarks in the course, this is the piriformis muscle. Okay, it enters the gluteal region through the greater sciatic foramen below the piriformis. It is covered by the gluteus maximus and hamstring muscles. It may be injured by intramuscular injection, by wrong intramuscular injection. Regarding the termination, here is the termination in the middle of the back of the thigh by dividing into two branches: tibial nerve, the medial one; common peroneal nerve, the lateral one. So the branches, muscular branches to the hamstring, biceps, semitendinosus, semimembranosus, and the ischial part of the adductor magnus. It gives articular branches to the hip joint and the knee joint, and the two terminal branches, the tibial nerve and the common peroneal nerve. Regarding sciatica, what is sciatica? Sciatica is pain along the sensory distribution of the sciatic nerve. What is the cause of sciatica? It is due to compression of the nerve root by prolapsed or herniated intervertebral disc. So regarding sciatic nerve injury, what are the causes of sciatic nerve injury? Of course, the first one, the commonest one, is wrong intramuscular injection. The second one, it may be compressed by the piriformis muscle. Regarding the effect of sciatic nerve injury, motor paralysis and the sensory loss of sensation. So it causes paralysis of muscles, hamstring muscles in the back of the thigh, and the muscles of the leg and the foot, which are supplied by the tibial and the common peroneal nerves. Loss of sensation below the knee joint, except the medial side of the leg and the foot. Why not the medial side of the leg and the foot? Because these areas are supplied by the saphenous nerve. What is the deformity caused by sciatic nerve injury? Due to paralysis of the muscles of the leg, it will cause foot drop of the foot. This is the gluteal region, and this is the safest site of intramuscular injection, the upper outer quadrant. Then we'll talk about the two terminal branches of the sciatic nerve, tibial nerve and the common peroneal nerve. This is the tibial nerve, the medial one. This is the common peroneal nerve, the lateral one. So the origin. They are two terminal branches of the sciatic nerve, where in the middle of the back of the thigh. Termination. The tibial nerve terminates deep to the flexor retinaculum by dividing into medial and lateral plantar nerves. The common peroneal nerve terminates on the lateral side of the neck of the fibula by dividing into deep peroneal nerve and superficial peroneal nerve. Regarding the landmark, the tibial nerve is the most superficial structure in the popliteal fossa. In the leg, it is covered by gastrocnemius and soleus. The common peroneal nerve, the landmark, is the lateral side of the neck of the fibula. Regarding the branches, cutaneous branches, muscular branches. Cutaneous branches, the tibial nerve gives a very long nerve, this one, the sural nerve. The common peroneal nerve gives you two branches. This one communicates with the sural nerve. So this is the sural communicating nerve. And this one, the lateral cutaneous nerve of the calf. Actually, the common peroneal nerve lies on the medial side of the tendon of the biceps. So compare between tibial nerve and the common peroneal nerve. They are the two terminal branches of the sciatic nerve. Termination. The tibial nerve terminates deep to the flexor retinaculum by dividing into medial plantar and the lateral plantar nerves. The common peroneal nerve terminates on the lateral side of the neck of the fibula by dividing into deep peroneal and superficial peroneal nerves. The landmarks. The tibial nerve is the most superficial structure in the popliteal fossa. Then in the leg, it is covered by gastrocnemius and the soleus. The common peroneal nerve lies on the medial border of the biceps, then on the lateral side of the neck of the fibula. Regarding the branches, cutaneous branches, the tibial nerve gives the sural nerve. The common peroneal nerve gives sural communicating nerve and the lateral cutaneous nerve of the calf. Muscular branches. The tibial nerve supplies muscles of the back of the leg, all the muscles of the back of the leg, superficial muscles and the deep muscles. Common peroneal nerve doesn't supply any muscles. Okay, common peroneal nerve trunk itself. Articular branches, tibial nerve supplies the knee joint and the ankle joint. Common peroneal nerve supplies only the knee joint. What is the commonest site of injury of the common peroneal nerve? The commonest site of injury of the common peroneal nerve is the lateral side of the neck of the fibula. That's why fracture neck of the fibula might injure the common peroneal nerve. If the common peroneal nerve is injured, then the deep peroneal nerve and superficial peroneal nerve are paralyzed. It will lead to paralysis of the anterior compartment and the lateral compartment of the leg. It will cause deformity called foot drop. This foot drop is due to paralysis of the dorsiflexors, and the foot will be inverted due to paralysis of the lateral compartment. Then the deep peroneal nerve. This is the deep peroneal nerve. Okay, deep peroneal nerve. It is one of the two terminal branches of the common peroneal nerve on the lateral side of the neck of the fibula. It terminates in front of the ankle joint, okay, by dividing into medial branch and the lateral branch. Regarding the branches, the deep peroneal nerve supplies the anterior compartment of the leg. So muscular branches to the anterior compartment, tibialis anterior, extensor digitorum longus, extensor hallucis longus, and the peroneus tertius. Articular branch to the ankle joint and joints of the foot, and then cutaneous branch. This is the deep peroneal nerve. It supplies the adjacent sides of the big toe and the second toe, this area. And the lesion of the deep peroneal nerve, it will lead to paralysis of the dorsiflexors, so the foot will be dropped. So foot drop. Regarding the superficial peroneal nerve, this is a superficial peroneal nerve. Superficial peroneal nerve, it is one of the two terminal branches of the common peroneal nerve on the lateral side of the neck of the fibula. It supplies, okay, it is called the musculocutaneous, supplies muscles and the skin. The muscles, lateral compartment of the leg, peroneus longus and the peroneus brevis. Cutaneous branches, it supplies the middle of the dorsum of the foot. The medial side of the dorsum of the foot is supplied by the saphenous nerve, femoral. The lateral side of the foot is supplied by the tibia, by the sural nerve, from the tibial nerve, and the adjoining sides of the big toe and the second toe by the deep peroneal nerve. So this area is supplied by the superficial peroneal nerve. Lesion of the superficial peroneal nerve causes only paralysis of the peroneus longus and the peroneus brevis, so loss of eversion. No foot drop, because the dorsiflexors are intact. Regarding the dermatomes of the lower limb, dermatomes of the thigh, dermatomes of the leg, and the foot. Remember the thigh, front and the medial side, 1 to 3. Upper part L1, middle part L2, lower part L3. Regarding the back of the thigh, it is S2. The leg, medial side, lateral side, and the back. Medial side L4. Lateral side L5. And the back, upper part S2, lower part S1. The foot, big toe L5. And little toe S1. So these are the dermatomes of the lower limb. They are very important in neurological examination to examine the sensory system. And thank you very much. Best wishes and good luck.